Good morning, Year Three. It is Friday. You've made it through to another week. Well done. Two more weeks till half term. You can do this. You're doing so well. Myself and Mrs. Watts are so proud of you. Right. So today we are going to be doing dividing two digits by one digit in maths. Now, I did make a bit of a false promise yesterday. I did build your hopes up and I'm really sorry. So what's happened is I was ahead of myself. So on Wednesday, I was doing a timetable for not next week, the week after. And that week is when we are starting to do money in maths. So I was ahead of myself and I was thinking about the last week for half term instead of next week. So we have actually got one more week of multiplication and division. Now, don't worry, you're all doing really, really well. I know this is a tricky unit. When we get back in school, we will go through more of this. So do not worry. If we need to pick up in places, that's fine. We're making notes, we're recording things down, you know, where things are being misunderstood or misconceptions when you are handing in your work. Do not worry, we will go through it. It's so much for you to be doing at home. We understand that. Okay. English, carrying on with talk for writing. PE, there is Joe Wicks there as an option, but again, if there's other things that you want to do, that's absolutely fine. And then the PSHE, the IELTS Challenge. Now, I have got a link up for you to have a look at the website. There's some lovely resources on there. It was given out the first week, but I understand with all the papers that we've had, I think we could probably chop down a tree with the amount of paper we're probably using each household with all this work. So don't worry if you've lost it, I can give you that again. Okay, so first of all, I'd like to have a little go at the four maths questions that's on the slide. Now, they are all things that we've been doing over the last week or two during our maths lessons, so you shouldn't find those tricky. If you look at the bottom, comparing statements, we've done that this week. So if you have a little go, you might want to pause the video now so you can have a go, and then we'll move on to the answers. When you press play, they'll come up for you, okay? Okay, so the first one should be 45. The second one, we've got 50. So if you're looking, you are multiplying your answer by 10. We've done that this week as well, haven't we? When we were doing the multiplication, you just apply the same with the division. Then the third one, the answer should be 72 legs. And then the last one, the crocodile is eating 742, because if you look in the tens column, the 40 is bigger than the 20 in 724. Okay, so in maths today, we are going to be doing division. So this might get a little bit more tricky and it might make you have to think a little bit more than what you have been doing in multiplication, if that's possible, because I know you've been working very, very hard. So for the first question, it is asking you to physically draw out the pencils. So in the tens column, you're going to put the boxes of 10. So imagine it like it's the base 10, okay? So like the base 10-6, and then the little pencils, the individual pencils on their own, are representing the ones. So they are representing the cubes, the little tiny cubes that we've been using, okay, in the other question, in the other lessons. So B, that again is just breaking it up. So don't let it confuse you when it says tens at the end. So for example, B, 8 tens, so that's the same as 80, isn't it? So the answer probably will have a zero on the end, but you've got tens there, so you don't need the zero if you remember. Okay, right, moving on to question four. You are using the part-part whole model here. Now this will help you to work out the division, because divisions are a little bit more tricky. So what it's done is it's got 69 there and it's split it into two numbers, into tens and ones. So if you do it in stages, so you do 60 divided by the 3 to begin with and pop the answer in the box, And then 9 divided by 3 and pop the answer in the box. And then you add those two answers together, which will give you the answer to 69 divided by 3. So you just do that for each one. Just take your time. You will get used to it. Okay? More practice makes perfect, remember. So question number 5, if you just do exactly the same thing, so it started drawing the part whole number for you, but you do need to finish it off. So for example, question number 5, you need to divide each number, so 90 and 3, by the number 3. So you just need to carry on drawing the part whole model, just like on the previous page. Okay, take your time. You will be fine, you can do this. Now, I'd like to have a little go at a couple of English activities, just like we did earlier on in the week. So, for the first one, which sentence uses commas correctly to separate the items? So, remember, we have done commas in the list. Some of you have been applying this in your talk for writing. Absolutely fantastic, you've done this beautifully. So, looking at the three options, which one do you think is the way to do it? So, read them very carefully. You might want to pause the video. Okay, so the answer is, I need a carton of milk, a loaf of bread, some fruit, and a packet of crisps. So it's the last one. The first one, after I need a carton of milk, a loaf of bread, some fruit, and a packet of crisps. I need isn't in the list, is it? The second one, I need a carton of milk, a loaf of bread, some fruit, and a packet of crisps. So that's not quite right either. If you read it out loud, you will start to realise which sounds correct, okay? So which sentence shows the inverted commas? So remember, inverted commas are speech marks. So have a look closely, which is in the correct place? Again, you might want to pause the video, just start to have a little look at those. Okay, and the answer is the second one. I am having nachos at the cinema, said Chantal. So if you have a look, you are, that's the part that she's saying. In the first one, at the cinema is the only bit it's telling us that she's saying, so that's not quite right. And then the bottom one, it's actually got the inverted commas around how she's saying it and who's saying it. So again, that's not quite right, okay? So what punctuation mark is needed for this sentence? Help me, I'm stuck. So again, you might want to pause the video. So the correct answer is an exclamation mark. So that's the fourth one along. So we've got a full stop, we've got a comma, we've got a question mark, and we've got an exclamation mark. So it's being said with emphasis. So it's needed to have an exclamation mark. It's not a question, we're not asking a question. Okay. So for the PSHE, the ELSA support website is brilliant. It's got some lovely free resources on there. So if you want to access that website, and then you can have a little look. The first one there, Express Yourself February Calendar, we did do that in January, that's similar. You might want to have a look at the new one, but then there are other options as well. So yes, Ray, I hope you have a lovely weekend. And I will see you on Monday. And I'm very much looking forward to seeing all the key worker children next week. So have a lovely weekend and I will see you soon.